The arrest of a notorious drug lord a decade ago in Afghanistan was heralded as a devastating blow to the Taliban. But now, Haji Juma Khan has walked free from an American prison. Caleb Maupin has been looking into the case.
Here at this correctional facility in Manhattan, you've got some very dangerous criminals. You've got the Mexican drug kingpin, Joaquin El Chapo Guzman. Furthermore, you've got the terrorist suspected of driving his truck into pedestrians here in Manhattan back in 2017. But one rather famous inmate, the Afghan drug lord, Haji Juma Khan, recently checked out, and no one knows why. Khan was first arrested back in 2001 as the USA began its operations in Afghanistan. However, he was almost immediately released. And from there, he went on to set up a criminal empire known as the Khan Organization. He was watched very closely by the U.S. Drug Enforcement Agency.
The Khan Organization arranged to sell morphine base, an opium derivative that can be processed into heroin in quantities as large as 40 tons. Enough to supply the entire United States heroin market for more than 2 years.
Now, it's also important to note that in Afghanistan, he became friends with the DEA's top man in Kabul. He described their friendship as crucial in getting information.
He was a major player in the global heroin trade, and our aim was to cut off the supply of money from opium kingpins like him to the Taliban and terrorists such as Al-Qaeda. He was an unofficial spy in the end. He gave us useful information that we passed on to the military.
At one point in 2006, the DEA chief in Kabul got so close to his drug lord buddy that he was worried he may have cancer. He arranged a trip for him to the United States in order to get treatment.
One day I noticed that he had a growth on his chest. I thought it might be cancerous, as I'd previously had a melanoma cut out and showed him my scars. I offered him treatment in D.C., and we went, although it was a false alarm. I was helping a friend, but also it was a way of building trust.
The friendship soured in 2008 when he was lured to Indonesia, arrested by Interpol, and then extradited to New York City. Once he was locked up pending trial, the DEA then publicly linked him to terrorists.
Proceeds from Haji Juma Khan Global Drug Trafficking Organization funded the terrorist activities of the Taliban. His arrest disrupts a significant line of credit to the Taliban that will shake the foundation of his drug network that has moved massive quantities of heroin to worldwide drug markets.
Ever since that time, everything related to Khan's case has been completely sealed. In 2010, the New York Times wrote about his long-standing friendship with both the DEA and the CIA prior to capture. At the time, neither agency would confirm or deny it, unlike his lawyer.
Several law enforcement agencies from the United States approaching people in Afghanistan, including Mr. Khan, and requesting assistance, and as I understand it, payments made, services requested from my client and others.
But now Khan is free. No criminal charges, no trial, and no explanation why. Now, at this point, perhaps we can assume that the law enforcement agencies know what's best for the public and just don't feel a need to share it. Their secret collaboration with the worst of the underworld, kept secret so you can sleep better at night. Caleb Maupin, RT, New York.